honored to have for the first time after its dedication, the September 11th Memorial here in the lobby. And we believed it would be appropriate to have a brief observance of today. We know it's etched in many of our memories. And I think that this ceremony will be very appropriate. We have several honored guests with us this morning that I would like to take just a moment to recognize. We have the chairperson of our Alamance County Board of Commissioners, Commissioner Amy Gailey. We also have Alamance County Commissioner Bob Byrd with us today. Thank you very much for attending. And we have representation from the Alamance County Sheriff's Office Honor Guard, as well as the Alamance County Fire Marshal. And we also have Reverend Graham, Darrell Peebles from the Graham Fire Department with us, who will be speaking. At this time, I'd like to ask if representatives of Fire and Sheriff's Honor Guard would please bring in the wreath and post it. So today from 8:30 a.m. till 10:30 a.m., we're gonna have representatives from the Sheriff's Office Honor Guard and the Alamance County Fire Marshal's Office posted on each side of the memorial. This represents the time period of the terrorist attacks, September 11, 2001. The memorial itself, I know many of you are aware, is actually a piece of World Trade Center Tower 2 there at the top. So we feel like having a vigil here this morning during the time of the original terrorist attacks would be very appropriate. And this time, I'd like to ask if the representatives of the Sheriff's Office Honor Guard and the Fire Marshal's Office that will be posted first would please go ahead and come forward. And this time I'd like to ask Reverend Darrell Peebles, chaplain of the Graham Fire Department, to say a few words and lead us in a moment of silence and a prayer.
Thank you so much. It's an honor to be here today. Anyone that's here that's about 20 years old and a little older perhaps and below probably do not remember that day. The others of us do very well. I wanted to share with you several different statistics that sound like numbers, but I want you to remember these are real and good people. There were 19 men that hijacked four airplanes. A total of 2,977 people were killed in New York City, Washington, D.C., and outside of Shanksville, Pennsylvania. At the World Trade Center, 2,753 people were killed. Of those who perished during the initial attacks, 343 were New York City firefighters, 23 were New York City police officers, and 37 were officers at the Port Authority. Victims ranged from age 2 to 85. At the Pentagon, 184 people were killed. At Shanksville, 40 passengers and crew members were killed. It was 8:46 when the first tower was struck and attacked. Subsequently, over the next hour, the other attacks took place. Everyone was impacted for the rest of their life that was aware of that moment. Not only did the nation change, the world changed. I personally was working out and training and saw it on the television. And as I watched that, at that moment, I made a decision personally to dedicate my life, what's left of it, to the fire service, being a chaplain and a firefighter. So many people's lives were changed that moment, and they each made personal dedications. Today, we realize that emergency systems changed because of that event. Communications changed. Security in every sector changed. You experience that now when you come in this building. Victims and responders were regular people doing their regular duties. And when they went to sleep the night before, they basically said, "I love you," and they left that morning looking forward to the plans they'd made the night before, and they never were able to live those out. We will never forget the evil and premeditated attack, but we're here today to not honor them, but to make ourselves aware that a small number of people in this world do carry on evil acts. The majority of you, however, are the silent heroes that go about your duties every day, wanting to do good for your community. And so today we remember and honor specifically those heroes who perished and also those who survived and are changed forever. Many of them injured, many families still in grief. And so today, as we gather here and we set up this memorial, remember those good people and decide upon yourself how that has changed you. After that, I became part of the Graham Fire Department and got a t-shirt. So I wanted to go to Ground Zero. I wanted to go to the museum. And when I went there, there was a deli across the street. And when I walked over to the deli, the owner of the deli told me his story. I share it with you. He was there right across the street when it happened. He ran into the lobby, and when it collapsed, it blew him 6 blocks away, and he was covered up, and they thought he was gone. They found his truck and his effects, and they gave that to his family with their sympathy. Weeks later, they found him in the hospital. Some of you people, like you, had gone in, dug through the rubble, found him, and he was alive. He was so excited, and he rebuilt his deli. This was several months later. And when he saw the shirt, it said Graham Fire. He said, "Are you a firefighter?" I said, "Yeah, I run about 300 or 400 calls a year, but it's no big deal." He said, "You come in, you eat anything you want, you drink anything you want." He was so appreciative of you people that serve every day in service like that. And I never will forget his face. I went back a few years later, his daughter was running it, and he was still there, and he still remembered that experience. And so that's just one example. Think of all the New Yorkers and all those people's lives, and then think about your own. Today, I ask that each of us, and each year at this day, we take that to rededicate ourselves to however we fit into the community and we serve every day. There's one thing that's really ominous about September 11th, and I'd like to point it out. It's 9-1-1. They picked the wrong day to pick on us, because 9-1-1 is always available and ready to respond. And so we thank all of those who, in that particular area of service, are there at every moment for whatever need might arise. At this moment, we want to take a short moment of silence, bow our heads, and reflect on what happened there, honor these people, and take a moment to rededicate our own selves to service in our community. Dear God, we thank you so much for this opportunity to gather and to remember not only the tragedy of that event 17 years ago, but to remember the wonderful people that responded, to lift up the families that were touched, not only there, but around the world. And the ripple effect through these years that has enabled us to be better equipped to respond to each crisis. We thank you for those people. We thank you for all those involved that very day and those after that and the tremendous cleanup and all the different aspects. And we thank you most of all for your presence in this world, where so many people respond to who you are, true love and dedication. And for those who still reject that and cling to evil acts, we pray for them, Lord, that their hearts would be touched. But keep us always ready for anything that might come, and to be willing to offer our lives also. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.
Thank you. Thank you, Reverend Peebles. In conclusion, I would just say, on behalf of Alamance County Government, thank you to each one of you for the service that you provide our citizens. That's from our emergency service workers to each and every person here in county government. The same spirit that ran through those folks that were responding to 9/11 is in each one of you, and it's very likely we'll be calling on you for help as the storm bears down on us. So I think it's appropriate for us to think of all the ways that that we serve. So thank you for taking a moment of your morning to join us here, and have a blessed day.